Trash can maybe be broken down,
really
so you can make a pile and then I think I can get it out of the
Today we are assembling and organizing a home in a box kit, which will provide brand new furnishings for flood survivors. This project today is actually incredibly timely. Flood survivors are just now becoming to reach a point where they're ready for these items. We've coordinated, orchestrated, and housed these items for them so that we could alleviate a lot of those nuances and that burden, those stressors that come along with trying to think about what you should have in your new home. This is actually a really rewarding day for me. We have worked with flood survivors from the early stages, from removing all of their initial items that were affected by the flood. So be able to replace those items to the flood survivors is something that's really meaningful, and I think it's going to be meaningful to them as well.
Even though there's so many other challenges on their road to recovery, we're hoping that these simple comforts can help be that first start for them. I mean, it's hard to say. I mean, every disaster is completely unique to the geographic area, and I would hate to say that a hurricane in Texas is more devastating to the people than flooding in Michigan, Midland, I think that all disasters are treated pretty much the same. It's just the amount of resources and the type of media buy-in, and we appreciate you all coming out here and letting people know that this is still an issue, and there's still a lot of resources and a lot of recovery to be happening. So I think what I've seen across the board for other voluntary organizations is the volunteer power. Traditionally, during large-scale disasters, you have folks coming from across the country to come down and serve, help clear debris, do food pantry stuff. With COVID, there's a lot more barriers, challenges, but it's not deterring a lot of these folks. And I think we still need to be mindful of all the different precautions that we need to take, but there's no reason that we can't still come out and serve.
Well, it's just amazing to me what the level of devastation was, and the fact that there were families just completely had their lives upended, being torn from their homes and having a lifetime's worth of possessions being wiped out essentially in a matter of hours. And so that was a very moving experience for me. I did not. I was spared. The water stopped about a half mile from where I live, so I was completely untouched personally by the flood and the dam failure, so I was in a position to be able to help others. Well, it's certainly a very fulfilling feeling in this sort of case. We're not going to immediately see the fruits of our labor, but you want to know that you helped, especially for me personally, being completely untouched by the flood. I want to be able to do something. I have the ability to do it, so I want to do it. And so that's a good feeling for me, and I just want it to be meaningful for those that it's intended to help.